In this video, we're going to look at how to graph the three types of lines with one intercept. These are the vertical lines, the horizontal lines, and lines through the origin. The first type of line with one intercept is the vertical line of the form x is equal to a, where a is a constant. Our first example is x is equal to 1. This is simply a vertical line through x is equal to 1. It is not a horizontal line parallel to the x-axis, a common mistake students make. And the reason it is a vertical line is because it doesn't matter which point on this line you take. All the points on this line has one thing in common, and that is they all have got the same x coordinate of 1. And hence, this line has got the equation x is equal to 1. The next example, x is equal to 4. This is also going to be a vertical line through x is equal to 4. By the same reasoning, it doesn't matter which point you take on this line, they all will have got the same x coordinate of 4. And the last example, x is equal to negative 2, by the same reasoning, will be a vertical line through x is equal to negative 2. The next type of line with one intercept is the horizontal line with equations of the form y is equal to b, where b is a constant. Our first example here is y is equal to 1. And this is a horizontal line through y is equal to 1. Just note that it is not the vertical line that is parallel to the y-axis. The reason it is a horizontal line is because it doesn't matter which point on this line you take. All the points on this line has got the same y coordinate of 1. So our next example is y is equal to 4. This is a horizontal line through y is equal to 4. By the same reasoning, it doesn't matter which point on this line you take. All of them will have the same y coordinate of 4. And by the same reasoning, y is equal to negative 3 is the horizontal line through negative 3. There are two special cases for vertical and horizontal lines. And these are when x is equal to 0, we have got the y-axis, because every single point along the y-axis, doesn't matter which point you take, they all have got the x-coordinate of 0. And the second case is when y is equal to 0 and we have the x-axis. Same idea, doesn't matter which point on here that we take, they're all going to have the y-coordinate of 0. The third type of lines with one intercept are lines through the origin. And these lines have got the equation of the form y is equal to mx. The coefficient of x, this variable m, represents the gradient of the line. It is a measure of the slope of the line, and we define it as rise divided by run. In other words, the change in the vertical distance delta y divided by the change in the horizontal distance delta x. So if m is greater than 0, the line will be sloping towards the right, and if m is less than 0, the line will be sloping towards the left. So if we know that these lines go through the origin and we've got information about the gradient, then we have enough information to draw the line. So our first example is y is equal to 2x. The line goes through the origin. That's going to give us the first point on the line. Using the fact that the gradient is 2, so we can write m is 2, and we can write this as plus 2 over plus 1. Or delta y, our rise, over delta x, our run, is plus 2 over plus 1. Now we're going to use the convention that going up or right, these directions are positive. Going down or left, these directions are taken as negative. So starting off at the origin, our first point on the line, we're going to move horizontally towards the right by 1 unit. That's our delta x, or our run. Then we're going to move up vertically, our rise, by plus 2. And that's going to give us the next point on the line. We then join up these two points to get the graph y is equal to 2x. So our second example, y is equal to 3x. We know that the line goes to the origin. That's our first point on the line. We then use the information that m, the gradient, is equal to 3, positive 3, which can be written as plus 3 over plus 1. So we've got delta y on delta x is equal to plus 3 over plus 1. So starting from the origin, we're going to move right by 1 unit. That's our run, delta x. Our rise, delta y, is plus 3. We move up 3 units to get our next point. We then join up the two points to get the graph y is equal to 3x. Our third example, y is equal to 2/3x. This line also goes to the origin. And then we're going to use the information that m is equal to 2/3. So this is the same as plus 2 over plus 3. So we've got delta y on delta x is equal to plus 2 over plus 3. So we're going to start at the origin and move horizontally towards the right by 3 units, plus 3, and up vertically by 2 units, plus 2, to get to the next point. Join up the two dots, and we now have the graph y is equal to 2/3. X. So you see that in all these cases, our m are positive and all these lines are sloping towards the right. In the following examples, we now have got negative values of m. So our first example, y is equal to negative x. That simply means negative 1x. So we can write m as being equal to negative 1 or negative 1 over plus 1. So we've got delta y on delta x is equal to negative 1 over plus 1. Since the line goes to the origin, that's going to be our first point, 0, 0. Delta x, our run, is plus 1, so we're going to move across to the right by 1 unit. But this time delta y is negative 1. That means we're going to go down by 1 unit, and that's going to be our next point. We then join them up to get the graph y is equal to negative x. Our next example, y is equal to negative 3x. This time, m is equal to negative 3, so we can write this as negative 3 over plus 1. So delta y over delta x is negative 3 over plus 1. So starting off at the origin, 0, 0, delta x, our run is plus 1, so we're going to move across to the right by 1 unit. Delta y, our run is negative 3 because it's negative, we're going to move down 3 units to get to the next point. We then join them up and we have got the graph y is equal to negative 3x. Our last example, y is equal to negative 1/4x. This time, m is equal to negative 1/4 or negative 1 over plus 4. So we can write delta y on delta x as negative 1 over plus 4. We again start at the origin. We're going to move across to the right. Our run, delta x, is plus 4. Then we're going to move downwards, delta y, our rise of negative 1. So going down 1 unit to get to the next point. We then join up and we have got the graph y is equal to negative 1/4x. Thanks everyone for watching the video. Hope it was helpful. For more videos on this topic and other topics, please visit our channel and please support us by subscribing. We'll see you all in the next video. Bye for now.